census out, the emphasis for the coming case was essentially, since the patient who had
Can we have the presentation, please? Dr. Maya.
So, the emphasis for this case was the presence of both ectopialentis along with myopic fraction macropathy. So the patient did not have any kind of marconoid aptus or anything like that. There were certain features which were suggestive of perhaps trauma. It's just a surgical video that I'll be showing. He's still loading the presentation. It's only a surgical video. So lastly, if you can see this few sphincter tears in the patient
and this
infero nasally subluxated lens, and no marconoid features as such systemically for the patient. So started with preparing the scleral tunnels prior to making any fusion or vitrectomy, so as the pressure of the globe is maintained. Primarily used a 20 gauge MVR for making the tunnels. And what was most interesting, so here doing the lens entry, what was perhaps most interesting in this patient was the presence of a posterior retinal break, something which I hadn't encountered in the past in a patient with myopic traction macropathy. So the management was to largely prepare for the scleral fixated lens and by preparing the tunnels, then finishing the vitrectomy, removing the cortical vitreous, which is largely responsible for the anterior traction of the traction metallopathy, and follow that up with the ILM beading, because thickening of the internal limiting membrane is largely responsible for the anterior traction, whereas the posterior traction is largely by the sphygmoma, which we can't really address. So one perhaps controversial thing while I was operating for me was whether to do an extensive peel or not, because the break was lying fairly posterior. I did go ahead and peel extensively, more towards the retinal break, which was almost at the arcades. Patients with MTM have very thinned out retina, so the risk always is that you might de-roof the fovea or cause foveal trauma. But keeping that in mind, keeping it as atraumatic as possible, it did go ahead and be as close to the break as possible, and follow that up by fixing the scleral fixated, implanting the scleral fixated lens using the Gabber's technique, and him using the end grasping for subscribe package. So I feel that the serrated forceps give a much higher grip as compared to non-serrated for pulling out the haptics. And after that, for tucking, I find the 25 gauge non-serrated and grasping forceps to be the most useful. The sphincter tears were there to tell me that there was likely trauma which was responsible for the ectopia or subluxation. The most interesting part was this break right here. Something I'm curious to ask my retina colleagues that if that's something that they have encountered as well. So that would be my time. Thank you.
I think a beautifully managed case. Did the patient have any history of trauma?
Yeah, he did
not
know
that.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Yeah.
No history that he was giving us that. But it's fairly obvious. Lots of sphincter tears there.
That would
and
explain the break also somewhat.
Perhaps I would expect a more peripheral brain trauma. But yeah, possibly given the
it's beautifully done, especially when you're peeling the LLM that, you know, material becoming away from the center. That's really beautiful, and it came out in one sort of a sweep. That's really nice, very well.
Thank you, Dr. Maya. We'll now have another presentation from Dr. Utkarsh Shah.